Strange things happen in American politics, like Elvis meeting Nixon. One of the strangest things ever to happen in American politics was the confirmation hearings of Clarence Thomas. Now, I've known Justice Thomas since 1984 when he chaired the combined federal campaign, and I was the deputy director of OPM, and he was chairing the capital region of it. And I've known Virginia and the justice a long, long time. And so I was on the radio on the West Coast when that abomination unfolded. And I never believed Anita Hill. I always believed she told a small lie, which became a big lie. The only way to describe what happened was to buy that theory. The only explanation for every detail was she lied, she got caught, she expanded a lie, no one believed her. But now HBO has made a movie about that, and I'm joined by Mark Pauletta, who's a partner at the L.A. Piper in Washington, D.C., very fine law firm, very fine lawyer. You can follow him at Mark Pauletta, P-A-O-L-E-A-T-T-A. Mark, welcome. How are you this morning?
Sure, thanks for having me on.
Tell us what HBO has done here and your objections to it.
Sure. HBO has made a movie that's dishonest to its core in an effort to boost Anita Hill's credibility more than it was at the time in the hearings. As you said, Hugh, and I completely agree with you, you know, she told all these little lies that never added up. You know, witness upon witness contradicted her. The only woman to come forward to say that Clarence Thomas ever sexually harassed her or ever talked about pornography with her. It was just a fantastical lie, as we sort of connecting up with the Duke LaCrosse case. But, you know, she wasn't believable then. When the American people watched those hearings, they determined 2-1, 3-1 that Thomas was telling the truth. You know, they got to watch this hearing. As much as it was a national circus, right, as Justice Thomas said, a circus, a national disgrace, they got to watch those hearings and assess the witnesses, and they concluded Thomas was telling the truth.
And, you know, Mark, what I like to tell people, I teach con law every year, and I teach my students about this period of time, and I covered it intensely. It occurred on the weekend when I was on the radio on the weekend, and I don't think I've ever been as angry because it was so patently and obviously a case of someone who had not succeeded going off and telling a lie as to why she had not succeeded. Her boss had been mean to her and abused her and harassed her. And then someone remembering that she had told that lie and dragging her unwillingly into the spotlight and inflating the lie into this giant helium balloon, which then burst. It's the only explanation. And they can have every New Yorker writer in the world who hates Clarence Thomas for reasons unrelated to his confirmation make up after-the-fact stories. But they never defeated that basic narrative.
That's exactly right, and you're dead on, Hugh. And in fact, I actually think she wanted to put it in play. I think that she actually called a friend in D.C., Gary Lyman Phillips, but it was Susan Hirshner who you're referring to. And you know, because of the lies, because of this hit job on Justice Thomas, I set up a website called confirmationbiased.com at biased.com, and on there, Hugh, I put a number of source documents, including the interview with Susan Hirshner that had been sealed for until now, and the interviews with Gary Lyman Phillips. I'm going to be putting up more documents to show what we were seeing at the time. You know, I was in the White House counsel's office. I was an assistant counsel to the president, and we were seeing this unfold and why her story wasn't credible. If you remember, Susan Hirshner, when she was interviewed by the Senate staff and when she first contacted the committee, she put that phone call that she had with Anita Hill in the spring of 1981, which is before she ever even went to work for Clarence Thomas. So that's the kind of stuff that you're exactly right. I think there was a lie that just got out of hand. She doubled down in the left because they wanted to defeat Thomas because he's a black conservative and he is a threat to the liberal order. And went straight in with her.
Okay, two interesting things I just learned there. I, too, was an assistant counsel in the White House. I didn't know that you and I shared the same job title, maybe the smallest office on the row there on old EOB land. But the other thing is, I always thought that Anita Hill was dragged kicking and screaming to D.C. And what you just said is, no, she put her hand up.
Yeah, you know what, Hugh, I actually think that she tried to take Thomas out behind the scenes. So, again, and I'd love to talk to you at length about this someday, but she actually calls a friend a couple days after Thomas gets nominated and tells him for the first time that Clarence Thomas sexually harassed her, and that's why she left the EEOC. It's that person, I'd say a 95% probability, who goes to the groups at a dinner party and spreads the story. There's no other way this story could have gotten into circulation.
Interesting.
For the fact that it was. So I don't think she ever wanted to testify. I think she just wanted to kind of try and take Thomas, you know, and throw something at him to kind of damage his chances. It spun out of control. And then I think the Senate staffers leaked her story, and that person has been written out of the HBO movie. But again, everything, Hugh, for your listeners, this movie is so dishonest You know, if you watch this movie, you would 100% believe Anita Hill was telling the truth. And they've taken out all the lies, the contradictions, all the things that didn't add up. And they've taken out all of Thomas's strong, you know, witnesses. You know, he had 12 women testify, former colleagues, who worked with both of them, right, who specifically said Anita Hill was not telling the truth. One of those women, Anita Hill, had given to the FBI as one of her corroborating witnesses.
When does it air, by the way, Mark? When's it air?
I'm sorry?
When does the HBO movie air, or has it already?
It actually aired. It started April 16th. I've forced myself to watch it a few times, and I'm actually going to be putting up on my site all the lies and omissions in that movie. But it's on HBO, and it's going to, you know, keep continuing.
Is it tanking in the ratings? Is it? I can't imagine anyone wanting to watch it because the right knows it's just a hit job.
I don't know. I hope it doesn't get many ratings, but I wanted to sort of combat it by putting up a site and pushing back against it.
So confirmation biased.
Yes, sir. ConfirmationBias.com.
Mark, good work. Keep working at it. And what kind of law do you practice at Dale A. Piper now?
I do congressional investigations.
Oh, very cool. So you defend people when they are the subject of congressional inquiry?
Yep. I was on the Hill for 10 years on the Energy and Commerce Committee. I did congressional investigations for 10 years.
Well, good for you. ConfirmationBias.com. Thank you, Mark. I want to go back and tell people about the Brexit. I always do a Brexit update.